This DNews episode is brought to you by domain.com.
Oh my God, you guys, there's an asteroid and it's gonna fly, but... I have just been informed that that happened on Monday, but it's still cool, guys. Hey, Astro Girls and Astro Boys, Trace here for DNews. Thank you for watching. Last Monday, 2004 BL86 made a spectacular flyby of our planet. It was the closest object to pass until 2027, when 1999 AN10 passes inside of the moon's orbit. That's pretty close. We know this because NASA's NearEarth Object Office has a list of everything that has or will pass close to the Earth from 1900 all the way to 2200. And just because BL86 was the closest in a while doesn't mean it's the only one. Asteroids ranging in size pass us all the time. Most asteroids are not necessarily discovered by NASA, but by organizations and astronomers the world over. BL86 was discovered in 2004 by MIT's Lincoln Near-Earth Asteroid Research Lab, or LINEAR. When a near-Earth object, or NEO, is discovered, the discovery is sent to the International Astronomical Union's Minor Planet Center. And if they confirm it, they give it a designation of a year, and then an alphanumeric combo. They measure closeness of these orbits in two ways, by AU, or astronomical units, or LD, lunar distances. 1 AU is the average distance from the center of the sun to the center of the Earth, and 1 LD is the average from Earth to the moon. BL86 was 0.0080 astronomical units, or 3.1 lunar distances from Earth. This sounds close, but 2015 BE92 will only pass 0.0083 AUs, or 3.2 lunar distances, and that happens today. And as you might have guessed from the designation, 2015 BE92 was only discovered this year. But let's not get into some fear-mongering, right? Come on, guys. Yeah, there are millions of asteroids flying around out there, and yeah, sure, some of them could end our existence, though you don't have to worry. Through hardy international efforts, we have cataloged 95% of all human extinction asteroids, which are those that are more than 1 kilometer wide, and none of them are gonna hit us. None. But just for fun, what if in that last 5% we did find one that was gonna hit? What would we do? It all depends on when we discover it. The sooner, the better. The more lead time NASA and other space agencies have, the better it will be for us. As Scott Hubbard, a professor at Stanford and former NASA employee, said, the reason dinosaurs went extinct is they didn't have a space program. We have to be looking for these asteroids. Aside from sending Bruce Willis and Batman to blow it up, which wouldn't work anyway, you'd have to blow up many bombs over decades to deflect a massive asteroid, but that's a whole other story. There is other ways to deflect them. My favorite plan is the gravity tractor. With a lead time of about 20 years, NASA scientists could construct and launch a craft, which would then park near an asteroid, wouldn't touch it. Then physics would do the rest. The gravity of that man-made satellite would slowly pull the asteroid off of its collision course over the period of, say, a year. And then boom, we're saved. There are no daring men and women risking their lives, just science. Switching gears for a moment though, we'd like to thank domain.com for this episode. No domain extension will help you tell your story like a .com or a .net domain name. And because you watch DNews, you can get 15% off of domain.com's names and web hosting by using the code DNews when you check out when you get a domain. What would you do to deflect an incoming asteroid though? You can tell us in the comments, you can subscribe for more DNews, both of those things are great. Also though, check out this video about the 4 biggest asteroid strikes ever. And that video, it's so old, look at how bad that green screening is. Oh man, you should just watch it for that. Thanks, see ya.